as a young doctor at the age of 24 at the St. Louis City Hospital, I entered the U.S. Army Medical Corps. That was in October of 1944. That was during World War II. The first orientation for all doctors was 6 weeks in the Army at Carlisle Barracks, Pennsylvania. I was then sent as a medical officer to a large Army General Hospital in Memphis, Tennessee. My major assignment was immediate care of 105 young soldiers with broken backs and paralyzed legs. In May of 1945, I was ordered to fly as a passenger on an airplane across the Atlantic Ocean to Prestwick, Scotland. That was the first time I had ever been on an airplane, and the flying time across the Atlantic Ocean was 13 hours. During that summer of 1945, I was assigned to duty with the War Crimes Commission. I performed autopsies on exhumed bodies of soldiers who had been dead 8 months. These were young American soldiers who had been murdered after they had surrendered. In other words, these dead bodies were autopsied, and they had been murdered after they had been taken prisoner. I had autopsy evidence in Munich, Germany, at the first trial of the first German sentenced to hang after the war. Following autopsies and court trials, I was sent back to serve as a physician in Army General Hospitals. Until I was returned by ship back across the Atlantic Ocean. There were 2,500 soldiers on that ship when we saw the Statue of Liberty in the New York Harbor. Returned by train to San Antonio and discharged from the Army in San Antonio in the fall of 1946.
So you were in there 2 years?
Yeah. Now, read it back. I might say this about the people in Germany. In reflection and review, the Germans could be depended on doing what they said they would do. And in the post-war years, they had a desire to maintain peace and have maintained peace in Europe since the days of World War II. I might add in closing that I have a trunk that I carried all of my belongings in.
Does it have any paper towels or any rags?
Yeah.
Not going to have any of the trash.
I have one relic that I have saved, and that's a trunk that I used in the Army. And you can see by the appearance of the trunk, there's quite a bit of wear and tear and travel for 2 years in the Army, and the appearance of that trunk, and it's got my return address in the Army of the 112th Evacuation Hospital. That was a number. Most everything in the Army has some kind of a number. And that was a number of the hospital where I was at the time that I used that trunk.
One more thing. I was going to get you to document the most amount of men that you helped. I remember you telling a story about having 100 and some odd men under your care.
Yeah, that was in a big ward in a general hospital in Memphis.
Mm-hmm.
My immediate duty was care with nurses of 105 soldiers who were paralyzed with broken backs.
Oh, okay. You said that in the other part. I remember talking about that.
But I had different assignments. Part of the time I was in Memphis in the hospital, part of the time I was in Germany in the hospital as a doctor.
Mm-hmm.
And you
only went to Germany one time, or did you go back?
Oh, I was over there all the time.
Really?
I was over there for more than a year.
Oh. Interesting. Yeah. I guess that about sums it up.
Well, that sums up enough of it.